I openly admit I am a terribly weak person. After giving it some thought, oh my goodness, I spent almost all day just basically thinking about Umineko, and jeez, that cliffhanger was too painful to freaking... I know I said I would do Fates Day Night, but the cliffhanger was just too painful and my curiosity won out in the end. I'm sorry for people who are watching Fates Day Night, I really am. I'm a terribly weak person. I'm not gonna do the normal intro, let's just get right back into this. I really wanna know what happens next. God damn it. Anyway. Hello, welcome back to Umineko. Let's jump right back in. Oh, but I will go ahead and mention this. I do have a close friend of mine who's going to be making a channel banner. A banner for my channel. Their name is Phidias, and I will put a link to both her DeviantArt and her Tumblr. Seriously, go check out her art. It's really, really good, and I can't wait to... We're kind of co-collaborating, sort of, on it. I'm trying to figure out a good design, and she said that she would do it. I think she would do it, yeah. But, anyway, there will be a link in the description where you guys can go check out her art, and I'll keep you guys updated on how the channel banner is going to look. I kind of had this idea, but I'm going to be having her do it. Check her out. Name's Phidias. There will be links in the description to both her DeviantArt and her Tumblr. So, please go check her out. Show her some love. She's got some really good talent. I'm not going to lie. They are inviting me. Ava, you okay? My heart leapt. Because there, gaping wide, was an opened mouth in the eerie darkness. When I strained my eyes, peering into the darkness, I saw something that looked like a light switch. In addition, there was a switch with open and close written on it. What the hell? When I resolutely pushed the switch, rough lights like you'd find in a coal mine turned on sporadically, making a staircase that stretched underground come hazily into vision. It was creepy how it now looked even more gloomy with the lights turned on. Other than the light switch, there was also a switch with open and close written on it. It would probably open or close this, but on the slight chance that the open part might be broken, I might be closed up in this creepy underground area for all eternity. So for the time being, I didn't touch the open and close switch, and as I readied my gun again, I slowly went down the stairs. Because the ceiling was very high, it didn't feel cramped. On the contrary, it felt as though a cool breeze was blowing upwards, and that creepiness even felt like an aura. As I readied my gun and carefully stared forwards, I went down the stairs. The walls, the stairs, the lights, all of them were very old-fashioned. It's easy to suspect that this had been made at the same time that the mansion had been constructed on this island. There were cracks in the ceiling, and water clung to the walls, constantly dripping down. That water fell into a gutter that had been set up alongside the stairs, then quickly and silently flowed into the underground darkness, as though it was telling me to go faster. The staircase kept turning back on itself. I don't know how far down I've gone, but I think it's much deeper than one floor. What the hell? And eventually, a rough metal door showed itself. So this seems like it's underground, from the rocks and everything. And there, characters had been written in a dark red paint. They had probably been written a long time ago. At the 10th twilight, the journey shall end and you should reach the village of gold. My heart, which was already about to explode, jumped about even more as soon as I recognized those deep red characters. There's no mistake. This is the last stop. Father's golden land. I calmed my throbbing heart, somehow regained my composure, and readied the gun again. But since in the end, I couldn't open the door with my gun held in both hands. I lowered the gun, carefully erased my breath, and opened the door. What the hell? My first impression when I saw the room was that it might be related to one of the rooms in the mansion. The walls looked gold. That's right, it had exactly the same atmosphere about it as the sealed VIP room on the second floor, but this was underground so there were no windows. There was only the solemn light of a grand chandelier. But even though it was dimly lit by the faint light, the quality of the interior was more than enough to take your breath away. A bed with a canopy and a rocking chair that looked like it would be comfortable to sit in. An extravagant sofa and carpet. The room was like a dream every girl yearns for at least once. And yet, since it was an underground hidden room with no windows, how could you say it? It felt like it could be the hidden house of a witch. I had never swallowed the legend of Beatrice, Witch of the Forest. However, after being shown this room, it certainly became hard to doubt that she actually had existed, and had lived in this room.
Dareka? Iru?
Even though I was completely shocked by this room, I carefully, no, timidly searched the interior with my gun raised. And, in the center of the room, I found it. What? My gasp came out strangely as though a bunny was being choked. Because after finding something like this, no one would be able to stop that kind of stupid voice from leaking out. You actually found it? On the opposite side of the canopy bed, it was piled up in a massive heap. It was a mountain. A mountain of gold ingots. Of course, they weren't piled up carelessly in a way that would damage the dignity of this room. A beautiful scarlet satin weave was laid on the mountain of gold, creating a beautiful three-colored mix between the red, the gold, and the black of the deep darkness. It was as though, when the witch slept on this bed, the gold would be a respectable chamberlain waiting on her. Nobly, refinedly, gracefully, beautifully. It was attentively piled there with an imposing air. When I tried to grab a single gold ingot, I was surprised at its weight. It was probably about 10 kilograms. Just this ingot would probably be worth more than 10 million. The Ushidamiya family crest, the one-winged eagle, was lightly imprinted on it. It was hard to tell whether it had worn away or whether the impression had been made carelessly in the first place, but it was certainly the crest of the one-winged eagle. Just how many ingots were piled up here? By just going from one part to another randomly and judging by the height, there were surely more than several hundred. My mind is already blank, so I can't do a good calculation. Even a moderate guess would put it above several billion yen. You okay, Ava? In front of the mountain of gold, I spread my arms and looked up at the ceiling. A laugh without a trace of dignity flowed out from my entire body. I had no intention of laughing in a weird way, but I couldn't hold back the happy feeling that flowed throughout my entire body. My older brother probably wouldn't accept his loss just because I had found this gold. But from now on, there would be no change in the fact that I had been the one to find the gold. To steal the headship of the family, I would still probably need some subtle tactics. But after everything I've gone through until now, that's a completely trivial problem. Even if I lost out on the inheritance of the Ushidamiya family and everything, I already have 20 billion yen worth of gold.
中にはお金で買えないものなんていくらでもあると思ってた。でもそんなのは嘘っぱちだって今理解したわ。
Jesus, Ava。
そんなのは持たざる者の自分への言い訳だったのよ。この黄金の山を前にして、私はやっとそんな当たり前を理解したわ。この世のすべての幸せはこの黄金を溶かすことで生み出すことができる。このお金があれば夫の会社はもう大丈夫。私たち家族はずっと幸せ。そしてジョージにも莫大なお金を残してあげることができる。
Despite being crazy, she's still thinking about her family. I guess that's good.
他の親戚たちなど、やがては没落して消えるわ。
Oh, well then. Okay.
その時、ジョージはこの黄金を使って、まるでお父様がそうしたように復興させてみせるのよ。その時、誰も異論を挟めないわ。ジョージこそが後ろ宮家の本当の跡継ぎなのよ。
Ava, please calm down. It happened. My wish was granted. That dream I have wished for ever since I was born into this world as Ushidomiya Ava had been granted completely in this very moment. My husband and I will be happy for all eternity. And I can also give my only son, George, eternal happiness. There's no way I'll waste it on foolish pleasures. My elder brother has chewed up the Ushidomiya family, but George and I will revive it. And that means that I truly have succeeded the headship of the Ushidomiya family.
もうこれで誰にも脅かされない。
Well, to say you're overwhelmed is an understatement.
That's right. After this, never again will we be smothered by sad nights.
おめでとう、あたし。
Hello!
おめでとう、うしろみやエヴァ。私たちの悲しい半生は、今ここに、すべての念願が叶って消化されたわ。
あなたのおかげよ。あなたの魔法があったから、このチャンスに恵まれた。このチャンスがあったから私はここにたどり着くことができた。
ありがとう。でも私の魔法は私たちの互いに信じ合わなくちゃ叶えることができなかった。だから私の魔法の力だけじゃない、私たちの勝利よ。だからこそおめでとう、私たち。
ありがとう、私。ありがとう、後ろ見合えば。今日までくじけなくてよかった。悲しみに溺れ、あがくことを忘れなくてよかった。これは私の魔法、私たちの魔法。あなたの魔法は本物だった。森の魔女ベアトリーチェなんてすでに幻想。あなたこそが本当の魔法が使える本当の魔女。
エイヴァ、
そうよ。あなたこそが今や黄金の魔女ベアトリーチェなのよ。
エイヴァ、you okay?
Okay. But the... Ava decided to leave that place for the time being. When she climbed the stairs again, trying to leave this secret place, she saw a creepy, swaying human shadow blocking her path, and her dreamlike state was blown away. For an instant, she believed that the true master of this room, the real Beatrice, had appeared. It seemed that the other person was also holding a gun. The two of them were pointing guns at each other, and eventually they each realized who the other was.
Rosa. Nee-san.
Don't tell me that she also figured it out. This might be a problem if that's the case.
こんなところで何をしているの? お互い様よ。 あなたこそこんなところへ何のご用?
ねえさんにヒントをあげるんじゃなかったわ。 What?
そうだったなら ここにたどり着いたのはきっと私が一番だった。
Rosa?
残念よ。
It seemed that Rosa knew where the staircase went and what was waiting ahead of her.
言うわね。私より遅くたどり着いたくせに。鮎の川に悩みすぎたわ。鮎なんて大した意味ないじゃない。 そんなことないわよ。立派なヒントだったじゃない。まあ確かに鮎である必要はなかったかも。でも鮎が海に出る魚だと聞いて私はそれで気づいたの。この奥には何が？自分の目で確かめたら？ あなたの想像をきっと裏切らないわ。怯えないで、姉さん。私はもともと当主が誰になるかなんて興味ない。後ろ宮の席だって興味ないしね。本音を言うと自分が当主になるんだってずっと威張り散らしてたクラウス兄さんから姉さんがその座を奪うなら かえって小気味がいいくらい。本気で言ってるの。もちろんよ。私は後ろ宮兄弟の歯車者。仮に私が当主跡継ぎだとお父様に指名されたとしても、それを兄さんたちが認めてくれるわけもない。そこまで甘い夢は見てないつもり。
私にも見せてよ。姉さんの勝利の証を。私は兄弟で取り決めした正当な取り分さえもらえれば、むしろ姉さんがこのゲームの正当な勝利者だと積極的に認めるつもりよ。私を撃っちゃえばこの黄金はローザの独り占めになっちゃうわね。それは同じよ。
I don't like this. For a tense moment, the sisters pointed their guns at each other. Eventually, after they sized up the glint in the other's eyes, they lowered their guns. Ava removed her finger from the trigger and held the gun upside down. It was a position that she couldn't quickly shoot from. When she saw that, Rosa held hers the same way.
そう。相手を撃って黄金を独り占めにしようという提案がお互いにとって魅力的ね。でも台風で隔絶したこの島から突然失踪すれば絶対に大騒ぎになる。ここに死体を隠せば簡単には見つからないだろうけど、それも絶対ではない。
何百億円の黄金があろうとも、殺人の罪を犯すリスクには割が合わないわ。むしろ
それを出しにされてクラウス兄さんたちに絞り取られるのがオチね。同感よ。ここに現れたのが兄さんやルドルフであるくらいなら、あんたであったことは不幸中の幸いかもしれない。
I don't know. Rudolph seems a little bit more trustworthy, I think.
私は兄弟であんたを一番信用してるのよ。
Which probably isn't that much.
ありがとう。私も姉さんのこと兄弟で一番信用してるわよ。私も黄金が見たいわ。見る？私ももう一度見たくなった。この目で見たにもかかわらず、まだ現実感が湧かないの。あなたと一緒に見て、確かに存在することをもう一度確かめないと、霧になって黄金が消えてしまいそうな気がするわ。
Anybody else kind of feeling a little tense here? Ava started descending the staircase once more. However, she didn't carelessly expose her back to Rosa. Even though at a glance it looked like Rosa had lowered her gun, she definitely didn't show any signs of carelessness. And they reached that room of the witch once again. Rosa also gasped, made speechless by the vast amount of gold.Rosa and Ava walked absent-mindedly through the rose garden. They had left the gas house secretly, so they had to be careful when they returned. They had to regain their sense of tension soon.
おめでとう、姉さん。ありがとう。姉さんが決めたのよね。後宮家当主後継ぎの肩書きに5割って。ここで聞いてくるとはね。今やそれはクラウス兄さんのことではない。だから姉さんの取り分が5割とその4分の1で125億。すごい取り分じゃない。私は25億で満足よ。ルドルフ兄さんだって文句は言わないわ。文句を言うのはクラウス兄さんだけでしょうね。
Obviously.
そうね。何しろ六軒島の実質的管理者は兄さんだもの。そしてその敷地内に黄金があった以上、第一発見者が私でもうまくことを運ばないとややこしいことになりそうよ。
Yeah, I would assume so.
ならないわよ。そこまでをも想定して私たちは昨夜散々議論を尽くしたんじゃない。果たしてそううまくいくかしらね。私はもうすっかり興奮は冷めてるわよ。ここからの調整の方がむしろ問題ね。それは新しき後宮家当主の問題ね。姉さんが楽しむべき問題よ。私には関係ないわ。言うわね。第二発見者として姉さんに協力するから、どうか例の前払い分、私の1億5000万だけは3月までにお願い。
いいわ。私に協力するならそれくらい気前よく払うわ。私は兄さんじゃないもの。
Ain't that the truth? You certainly hate him enough.
とりあえずは兄さんたちを驚かせましょう。実際の場所は伏せるにしても、早くクラウス兄さんの驚く顔が見たいわ。
I imagine you do.
ちょっと待ってよ、ローザ。それをみんなに伝えるのはまだ待って。
Why?
どうして？
バカね、決まってるでしょ？相手はあの尊大なクラウス兄さんに、ずる賢いルドルフなのよ。やがては発表するにしても、今はまだ早いわ。 どうやって話を進めるか慎重に検討してからじゃないと。せっかく見つけた黄金を全て兄さんにかすめ取られることもありえるわよ。
Even though technically you guys were the ones that find, even though you technically solved the epitaph, you followed the rules, I guess. Ava tried to say it as though it was completely obvious. So when she saw Rose's expression suddenly cloud over, she was a little surprised.
何か不満なの？クラウス兄さんたちの性分はあんただってよく知っているでしょうが。
姉さん、それはルール違反よ。
ん？
何の話よ。
What?
私たちは誰が黄金を見つけてもすぐに報告するというルールになっていたはずよ。
Oh, shit, that's right.
それをしぶればルールの根底が崩れて後で何かの火種になるかもしれないわ。クラウス兄さんが狡猾であるならばあるほどに、そのルール違反は後でこじれるわ。
バカ言わないで。ここは兄さんの島なのよ。そしてさっきの黄金はキャッシュじゃない。10トンもの莫大な換金物の山なのよ。運び出して現金化するには相当の手間をかけるわ。そしてそれはこの島を実効支配している兄さんにあらゆる面で有利に働くわ。そんなこともわからないのあんたは。
そういう腹の探り合い、私は好きじゃないの。
I just want to clearly specify my,
もちろん、姉さんが私に現金25億を今すぐ渡してくれるなら、あとは姉さんがどう交渉しようと勝手よ。
Rosa.
でも、私の取り分が手元に入るまでは、私は兄弟のルールを遵守するわ。
何を甘いことを。あんた、兄さんのずる賢さを何も分かってない。
It wasn't that Rosa didn't understand the craftiness of her older siblings. In that sense, Rosa more or less understood Ava's caution. But in her heart, she couldn't clear away her suspicion that Ava wanted to keep all of the gold to herself. Because she knew that Ava was at least as crafty as her other siblings. In other words, Rosa wanted to put a stop to any chance Ava had to keep the gold all to herself, by quickly informing the siblings of the gold's discovery.
ローザ、悪いけど今だけは私の言うことを聞きなさい。
言うことを聞かないと1億5000万は用意できないってこと。
そういう言い方をしているつもりはないわ。でもあなたが本当にそのお金を必要としているなら、私に協力した方が現実的よ。兄さんたちに話せばその当然の取り分すらもなくなってしまうかもしれない。それは嫌でしょう。
For a while, a severe expression that she had never shown to her sister before rose to Rose's face. There wasn't even a trace of her restraint as a younger sister. There was just the ruthlessness. No, the seriousness of a single human arguing about a vast sum of wealth.Ava made light of it, chuckling.
やれやれ。物騒な殺人事件が起こったばかりで、その犯人がまだ島の中にいるかもしれないってのに。こんなところで立ち話なんて、私たちもつくづく不用心ね。
どうせ使用人たちの茶番でしょ。この島で殺人事件なんてもともと起こってないのよ。
あら。
は？
やっぱりそう思う？
6人の死亡状況ではっきり説明がつくわ。あの6人の密室は外部犯行では絶対に作れない。南條先生は全員死んでるって言ったけど、あれも嘘ね。これは全てお父様が仕組んだ手の込んだお芝居よ。使用人たちはみんな死んだふりをしているだけよ。もともと殺人なんか起こってない。
But...
殺人犯なんかうろついてるわけがないの。
Rosa, are you okay?
へえ。あんたがそれに気づくとは意外ね。割と怯えてるように見えたから、そこまでは気づいてないと思ったの。
私、そういう場の空気は読む方なの。おかげさまで鍛えられたから。
That's right. Come to think of it, now that the servants are dead, everyone on this island is a member of the Ushidame family. And after Nanjo had proclaimed the deaths of the servants, when the relatives had begun to discuss the riddle of the Epitaph, he had disappeared off to the second floor as though he was on, in the way.
Svete. Watashi tachi ni hibun ni chousen shite morau tou oshibai. Dakara koso, nee-san ga shourisha de aru tou sengen ga hitsuyou na no ni. Ano shoushitai ga hontou no otousama no wake ga nai.
Well, what if it...
足の指の数が同じ死体をどこかで調達してわざわざ悪神に焼いてみせたのよ。
But we know from the truth that they are all dead.
きっとどこかに隠れて私たちがどう振る舞うかを監視してるわ。姉さんが黄金鏡に至ったこともきっとすでに知るところよ。だからこそ早く姉さんが勝利者であると宣言すべき。きっとお父様がどこからともなく現れて手を叩きながら姉さんこそが跡継ぎだと宣言してくれるわ。
I doubt it.
まあでも私は姉さんから1億5000万を無心しなくてはならない以上何も逆らうことなんかできないわね。
私の言うことを聞いて兄さんたちには黙っているということも。そこをはっきりさせなさい、ローザ。
私は話したいわ。ルールを定めたのはつい昨夜よ。それを保護にすべきではないわ。
もちろん必ず兄弟の前で発表はするわ。でもその前によく状況を確認したいのよ。10トンの黄金の運び出し、そして換金、公平な分配、それを兄さんに出し抜かれずに行える裏付けが取れるまでしばらく考える時間が欲しい。それまで発表を待ちたいというだけの話よ。決して独り占めしたくて内緒にするわけじゃないわ。
やがてはきっとみんなに発表するの。
もちろんよ。私だって早く兄さんの鼻を明かしてやりたいもの。
Wouldn't blame you. He's a
dick. 姉さんの言う考える時間というのはどの程度のものなの？
そんなの考えてみなくちゃわからないわ。
一晩あればそれは十分。
一晩ってそんなの約束できないわよ。
次期当主の姉さんに敬意を表して一晩は姉さんに協力するわ。今年の親族会議は台風が通り過ぎて船が迎えに来る明日の朝まで。そうね、ウミネコの鳴く頃にはお開きになる。
Oh, she said the title.
そこまでは私も黙ってることにする。それ以上の考える時間が必要だというのならその時に改めて相談しましょう。私は最大限汲み取って協力するわ。
あんた食えないわね。びっくりよ、それだけのたくましさがあったなんて。
女は子を持つと強くなるって本当ね。マリアを産んで私はそれを強く自覚したわ。
分かったわ。とりあえずはあんたの協力に感謝するわ。明日の話は明日すればいいことよ。
ええ、そうね。姉さんが黄金を独り占めにするなんて考えない。 公平な当主跡継ぎだと信じている。もちろんでしょ。ちゃんと黄金は兄弟で山分けするわよ。
いやよ。これは私が見つけた。私たちが碑文の謎を解いたんだから。だからこの黄金は全て私のものだってば。誰にも譲らないわ。私が後ろ宮家の当主なのよ。私が。
The witch inside Ava claimed exclusive possession in a loud voice. Of course, that didn't reach even close to Rose's ears, and it probably didn't reach Ava's either. What?
わらわがそれを認めようぞ。
What?
そなたこそ魔女の碑文に選ばれし、正当なる後ろ宮家の当主。
What?
今こそそれを我が名において認めようぞ。
What?
あんたは?
Wait, what the hell?
その格好、まさか本当にベアトリーチェ。
Wait, hold the actual phone here. So, wait a minute. You can't be serious. Are you telling me that... Hold on. Maybe Beatrice was happy that Ava called her by her own name. She cackled pleasantly. In concert with that laugh, gold butterflies crept up as though a storm of gold dust was spinning around the room, and the room shone the color of gold.
わらわが黄金の魔女、ベアトリーチェである。そう怯えることはないぞ。わらわはそなたの偉業をたたえておる。本当に素晴らしい。あの碑文の謎を見事解いてみせたのだ。わらわを感嘆させるに値する
。
あの手紙の差出人はあなた?なら私は全ての黄金と後ろ宮家の家督を引き継げるのよね。あなたはそうあの手紙に記したわ。そして私はその挑戦に打ち勝った。
わらわはそれを認めようぞ。今やこの積み上げられた黄金の全て、後ろ宮家の全てをどうしようもそなたの自由ぞ。何しろ今この瞬間よりそなたはもう後ろ宮家の当主なのだから。
本当に?本当よね?本当よね?
興奮するでな。わらわはそなたを率直に褒めた。その証そなたにこれを授け。
Beatrice took a ring off of her own finger and held it out to Ava. She fearfully accepted it and realized that it was a ring.
これ、まさか。
金蔵より返還された後ろ宮家当主の証である黄金の指輪。今よりそれはそなたの。それを指にはめ、兄弟たちの前で高々と掲げるがよ。そなたが今や後ろ宮家の家督を継いだことに誰も疑いを挟めぬであろうぞ。
Wait, hold on. Yeah, are there two Avas? Wait, Okay. Ava stared closely at the ring. It certainly wasn't a fake.Without a doubt, it was the real thing. She had dreamed of receiving this ring someday, focused on this day over and over again, and it was now finally a certainty. This ring had now designated her as the head and had been handed over to her. And timidly, she put it on the middle finger of her left hand. In that instant, she felt a deep emotion piling up inside her that she had never felt before. Her mind grew blank. Both eyes were opened. That ring was on her own finger.Not in a dream, in reality.
その指輪も喜んでおる。それほどまで指に通すことを夢見ていたそなたのもとへ行くことができたのだ。
指輪、お父様の指輪。
そのようにして自らの指に通す。どれほどの世に夢を引き、その思いの強さ、そなたの魔法に通じ、それを実現させたのだ。そなたは今や立派な魔女を名乗る資格があろうぞ。
あなたは何者なの？本当にベアトリーチェなの？
我こそは黄金の魔女ベアトリーチ、後ろ宮家顧問錬金術師。金蔵との契約にしたそなたに今こそ全てを受け継ごう。金蔵に託した全ての黄金、そしてそれにより築き上げた全ての財産、そして後宮家の家督と名誉、そして我が力と無限の魔女の称号をそなたに引き継ぐ。
Wait, what?What?
わらわのすべての魔女、無限の魔女にして黄金の魔女の称号をそなたに引き継ぐ。先代にして称号とともにわらわのベアトリーチェにそなたに譲り渡す。今こそそなたが名乗るがよかろう。
What? Ava gulped.The chandelier light, which had seemed dim, now felt too bright.
バナナにおいて、これより黄金の魔女の継承を執り行おうぞ。
The instant that Beatrice made that proclamation, everything was buried by a golden sparkle and changed into a majestic place that looked like an audience hall. In the audience hall, there was a crowd of Beatrice's minions and brethren.As well as countless gold butterflies celebrating this first succession ceremony in 1,000 years. When she looked, she saw Beatrice on the throne that only the Endless Witch was permitted to sit in, holding a golden staff, reigning with a dazzling dignity. Without being ordered by anyone, Ava automatically kneeled, hanging her head. Hi! A goat attendant respectfully handed Beatrice a golden staff in the shape of the one-winged eagle.After Beatrice stood up and received that staff, she laid the tip of it on Ava's shoulder and spoke. It was a proclamation 1,000 years in coming.
Ushiromiya, Ava, Sonata, Majo no Kibun no Nazo o Minko, Kono Ogon Kyo e Tadori. Sonata ni Mugen no Mahou no Sube.無限と黄金の両魔女の称号を引き
継ぐ。 What?
どなたはベアトリーチェを名乗るがよかろう。さあ表を上げよ、そして立ちてこの杖を受け取る。
ありがたき幸せ。
Ava, Beatrice. Ava stood up dizzily and took the magic staff from Beatrice's hand. Her hand was trembling slightlyAs soon as she grasped that staff, she was wrapped up in the brilliant sparkle of gold, as the gold butterflies were flowing up from inside of her. In the instant she succeeded the Golden Witch, Ava felt something in the depths of her soul be reborn. To describe it in a word, it was energy. Energy with a gold color. It felt like she was waking up, as though she had been half asleep since she had been born and was opening her eyes for the first time. It felt as though her true eyes inside her eyes were open for the first time in her life.What the? What the hell? Wait a minute! Burn Costal and Lambda Delta?
どなたこそが今や新しき魔女であることを知らしめてやるがよい。
Ava, no. The new Beatrice turned around timidly. When she did, the witch's minions, which filled the vast audience hall, honored her with an applause that sounded like the roaring of the sea.
So, Minanomono, Beatrice's
shoujougao,
sbete atarashiki Beatrice ni sashikae yo.
Huh?
Atarashiki Beatrice ni iwai no kotoba o sasage yo.
What the? Virgilio?
お待ちつきを期待しています。お師匠様、今は真面目な儀式中なんだから、そういうのはなしで頼むよ。黄金の魔女の結晶、おめでとうございます。私はロノウェと申します。
This is extremely bizarre.
この男に相談すれば晴れるであろう。そして先代ベアトリーチェ様、ようやくこうしてお会いできたのに、これ以上のお使いを許されず、とても残念です。お、what?この洗礼を兼ねとても楽しく過ごさせていただきました。深く感謝いたします。
魔女の子、どうかよろしく頼む。はい、先代ベアトリーチェ様の最後のご冥福で、このロノまで、しかと聞き届けました。感謝しなさいよ。あんたの魔女継承の推薦人にサインしてあげたんだからね。つまり、
Well, that voice. I should have recognized that sound. That sounds eerily similar. Okay, I've been doing well at this, but I'm sorry. Can we just turn this down just a little bit, please? Sorry. I really am.
まあ、不遇の少女時代と報われない努力にね、ちょっとだけ同情しただけなんだから。別にかわいそうだからとか思ったわけじゃないわよ。うぬぼれないでよね。そうだ。
Soon?
私から見れば、あなたの継承は、まあ奇跡というよりは偶然ね。 私が推薦するのは私も。
こちらはベルンカステル卿。
Yeah, someone who sounds and looks very similar to evil, Rika. Or the creepy Rika. There we go. Creepy Rika. Fuck, I don't know.
だが、こうして参列し、祝福してくれただけでも行幸というものよ。
千年ぶりの珍しいイベントだから来ただけ。
Where'd you go?
美味しいお酒も出るそうだし。新しきベアトリーチェ様、oh. ぜひ私たちにもご挨拶させてください。
え、あ、どうもはじめまして。
The seven sisters of purgatory were gathered in a line. The eldest sister, Lucifer, took a step forward and kneeled.
こやつらはわらわに使いし神たち、継承祝いにそなたに使わせた。
Just gonna take a quick sip of water.
そなたには黄金の魔女を継承した後、自らの復活の儀式を執り行ってもらわねばならない。その儀式において煉獄の七姉妹たちは欠かせぬ役割を果たす。癖をのぞろいだが役には立つぞ。手足とするがよい。
常にベアトリーチェ様のおそばに。何事もお命じください。必ずや遂行してご覧に入れます。
I wonder if Battler has anything to say about this. Even after that, various nobles and minions visited and offered words of congratulation for the new witch. As she responded to them confusedly, she felt as though she was getting lightheaded due to lack of oxygen. She couldn't tell if this was something real or unreal, but there was just one thing she could understand. A feeling of achievement at being permitted to call herself the Golden Witch. That alone was a truth she could definitely understand.
Why? What is this?
Now you're finally coming up to asking questions.
Of course, I'm not going to do anything. What is this?
Good lord.
エヴァおばさんが新しいベアトリーチェに魔女になっちまったっていうのか。そんなバカな。
わらわも驚いている。まさかあの碑文を解く者が現れるとは。しかしそういうルール、わらわはそれに乗っている。黄金の魔女の座と我が名を引き継がねばならない。
驚かれるには値しますまい。お嬢様はもとより、そういうルールを手紙に記されて公示されております。エヴァ様がそれを最初に成し遂げた、それだけのことでございます。
What happens to current Beatrice and you?
ヴァルギリア、いるか。
はい、おります。とも、
えい、
この茶番が意味するところは何だ。おかしな魔女たちが次々と現れる描写はあいつのされ事だとしても、これじゃまるでエヴァおばさんが魔女になっちまったみたいじゃないか。
落ち着いて。黄金の魔女という称号が継承され、あるいは以後自称するだけに過ぎません。この継承式はそれをあの子の解釈で演出したものに過ぎないに違いない。同じ手に何度もかからないで。
そうだ、この盛大な式典は全てまやかしだ。だがエヴァおばさんが碑文の謎を解いたことまでは事実。そしてそれは同時に後宮家の家督を受け継いだことも指す。そして10本の黄金を得たということは、エヴァおばさん黄金の魔女を自称してもいいということなのか。
いや、
くそ、相変わらずややこしいことをしやがって。
Does that mean that she's going to be taking Beatrice's place in this game, or is she going to participate?
やれやれ、無粋なる人間には 式典の荘厳さを介することもできぬだ。まあ、空気を読めぬのが人間という。
I don't know, Rosa was able to read between the lines.
そなたを哀れには思う。責めはせぬ。
くそ。かわいそうな人を見るような目で見やがって。だが、とりあえず確認をする必要はある。それはあの、若返ったエヴァおばさんみたいな分身。
Yeah.
つまり、新しいベアトリーチェとかいうやつの定義についてだ。あれは何なんだ。
わらわがそれを語ろうとも、どうせそなたは魔法は信じぬ、魔女は信じぬの一点張りである。だからわらわから説明することは特にない。そなたが思う通りに信じればよい。
俺が思う通りだと？じゃあどう解釈すればいいんだ。
後ろ宮エヴァの内面的別存在の資格かと今は捉えていただき、差し支えないかと思います。
Possibly a split personality born from her, you know, sort of abuse as being raised?
もちろん鵜呑みにはできませんが、今はそう理解するのが妥当でしょう。
That would be the only explanation that I could think of without relying on magic.
つまりエヴァおばさんも彼女も同じ人物だと理解すべきなんだな。クソ、なんだか気持ち悪い展開になったぜ。
そういうわけ、これよりベアトリーチェはわらわの名ではない。
What is your name?
後ろ宮エヴァに引き継いだ。というわけで、わらわは名なしだ。
What?
バトラー、何かわらわに適当なふさわしき名はないものか。
I could pick a few choice words that I'm pretty sure Battler would say, but...
どなたの推薦を受けるぞ。何か上品で気品あふれて、できればちょっぴりキュートな名前はないものか。
お
前なんかベアトのまんまで十分だぜ。ベアトとベアトリーチェで十分区別つくだろ。
ベアトのままか。違和感はないのに、なぜだかつまらん。
We got Maria who says ooh, now you got Beatrice says moo.
紅茶の温度と女心はいつの時代も難しゅうございます。
バトラ君、とにかく以後は冷静に。この子がベアトリーチェだった時に比べれば、現在の彼女は後ろにエヴァと判別がつくだけ、私たちに状況は有利です。
だからこそかえって気に入らねえんだよな。何を考えてるんだベアとのやつめ。
Over there, the witches formed a long line to bless Aunt Ava, who had the figure of her younger days and who now possessed the name Beatrice. It was like a witch's coronation. The countless gold butterflies flapped their wings, directing this fantastical gold sparkling space. They were all praising her. As I stared from the distance, I looked at the reborn Beatrice, who had a slightly embarrassed smile on her face. Her expression, which had been confused at first, seemed to be full of happiness that she had finally become aware of.In that expression, there wasn't a trace of the insane laugh from standing before the gold. There was an innocence which reflected upon her own joy. Since I denied witches, I couldn't put on a joyful expression at this witch session ceremony and accept her. However, when I looked at that innocent smile, it made me feel like I wanted to bless that just for now. The moment when a strong effort is successfully rewarded is always beautiful. Aunt Ava, who had always yearned to succeed the head and had worked hard since she was young without being rewarded,spectacularly taken hold of the chance given to her by the riddle of the epitaph, and had finally gained that position. How divine is the smile of a person whose childhood dreams have been granted. I definitely won't accept witches. But, Valor put his hands together, making a small sound. It didn't reach her ears, but it did bless her.
おめでとうよ。
You spectacularly solved the riddle of the epitaph before anyone else. It's your victory without any complaints. I won't accept all that about the Golden Witch and so on, but I will accept you as the new head of the Ushidomiya family, and I will celebrate honestly. As though dragged along by Battler's applause, Beato also clapped. It was a slightly odd scene, because Battler and Beato, who opposed each other, were standing next to each other, applauding for the same person. Don't tell me you two are starting to get along. Incredibly odd. Beato laughed impishly, playing around and applauding even louder, as though eagerly trying not to lose to Battler as she clapped. Battler went along with her and clapped even louder. God damn it! When he did, as though some ceremony had ended, everyone applauded and highly praised the reborn Beatrice. It was just as though Battler's and Beatrice's applause had been the final thing needed for her succession. That was a sudden stop to the music. Oh! Okay. Where's the clock? There's the clock. No time passed? I'll go at it for another hour. I seem to be doing this a little bit more often than I should, but I need to know more. Rosa returned to the lobby. It was still her time to rest, but her expression made it look as though she couldn't sleep deeply with all this tension.
次の人、休んでもいいわ。キリエさんたちはいかがですか？どうする？ルドルフさん、休ませてもらう？キリエは休んでいいぜ。俺は起きてる。それくらいしか男らしいことができない。じゃあ起きてるわ。夫と一緒に起きてるくらいしか女らしいことができないか。
Good lord, you two.
本当に仲のおよろしいことで。Yep.
夏日さんこそね。エヴァとヒデヨシさんはぐっすりみたいじゃないか。やはりローザと違い、年には勝てない。As
though in response to those words, the door to the hall clunked open. Eva and Hideyoshi returned from the guest room.
余計なお世話よ。あら、ローザ。もう休んでなくていいの？姉さんこそ。無理しないで休んでたら？なんだか寝つけなくてね。シャワーを浴びたら眠気が覚めちゃったわ。ルドルフたち、よかったら休んでいいわよ。
Oh, thank you. 今は気持ちだけでいいぜ。兄貴たち、先に休んだらどうだ？
ありがたいね。だが先に休むわけにはいかん。それくらいしか長男らしいことができないのだね。
You guys are being a little,
私たちは最後まで起きていますので、ご心配なく。
それよりエヴァ姉さん、大丈夫？少し顔色が悪いわ。
そういや、そうやな。ん？ちょいと熱っぽいで。
You okay, Ava? Hideyoshi put his hand up against Ava's forehead. It seemed that Ava wasn't feeling her best.
言わんこっちゃねえ。歳のくせに生活リズムを崩すからだぜ。風邪か？
夏日、上の南條先生を呼んできてくれるかね。
はい。いいわ、そこまで大げさじゃない。常備薬は持ってるから大丈夫よ。疲れるとすぐ熱に出るの。心配しないで。
姉さん、無理しないで。
ありがとう。私抜きで兄弟が集まってると、私の陰口でも言われてるような気がしちゃってね。昔からの被害妄想なの。ごめんね。
私は何も言わないわよ。姉さんのいないところで、姉さんの嫌な話なんて。どうしたの？姉さん、さっきから変よ。もう少し休んだら？
そうね。3月までの金策を考えたら、頭痛がひどくなってきちゃったわ。
ん？
それは良くないわね。休んでて。姉さんの頭痛がひどくならないよう、私も自重してるわ。私だって頭痛、さっきから辛いし。
ありがとう。じゃあ私、お言葉に甘えて、もう少し休ませてもらうわね。
どうしたんや、エヴァ。急にへそ曲げて。すまんな。わしら、もうちょい休ませてもらうわ。すまんな。すまんな。
After apologizing several times as though praying, Hideyoshi went after Ava and left the lobby.
Yeah, of course.
Come to think of it, we haven't really heard much of anything about
Maria. Maria が心配だわ。
It's just been focused heavily on the adults.
こういう時は癇癪を起こしやすいの。
At that time, they heard the sound of wild footsteps on the second floor. The guest house wasn't a cheap building, so they wouldn't normally have heard the sound of footsteps. It was like the sound of someone stamping their feet in frustration. And in a flash, in addition to the sound, which seemed to be caused by her running around the second floor, they could hear Maria calling "Ooh" over and over again, sounding displeased. Rosa grabbed her head, her hair flying, and she voicelessly moaned in anguish. The adults conscientiously turned their backs to her, pretending not to notice. The noisy clamor came down from the second floor and flew into the lobby. It was Maria who was sobbing along with the other children in Nanjo. In other words, they had all come downstairs because of Maria's tantrum. Rosa couldn't hide her dizziness at this new annoyance her daughter was bringing to everyone.
ごめん、Rosa おばさん。私たちもなだめたんだけど、どうしても聞いてくれなくて。
Maria? What the hell?
どうしたの、Maria?少し静かにしなさい。みんな見てるわよ。
例のバラ庭園のマリアのバラ、あれが急に心配だと言い出して。寝ぼけたみたいなんです。急にガバッと起き出して、バラが心配だ、バラが心配だって言い出して。マリアちゃん、落ち着いて。それは
夢なんだよ。
Don't hit her. The sudden rise in the tone of Rosa's voice surprised the children, but Maria's crying just grew louder and her tantrum just grew fiercer.
Rosa-san, 子供を頭ごなしに叱ってはいけませんぞ。こういう時は温かい牛乳などを与えると良いものです。
Listen to the doctor, Rosa, please.
さっき朝食代わりに出した牛乳で空っぽです。
誰か子供用の鎮静剤とか持ってるか？ほら、あの銀の粒みてえなやつとか。
持ってるわよ。ああ、今探して飲ませるから。
Rosa? Without hiding her displeasure, Rosa grabbed the handbag that had been set on the sofa and fished around for some medicine. It seemed that she had brought some child-use sedatives for Maria's tantrums. She found it and opened the bottle, but it must have been empty. Irritated, Rosa shook the bottle several times, but that didn't change the fact that nothing was in there. As she did that, Maria's crying grew even more intense. At that time, Ava was lying on the bed, covered by the bedding. Hideyoshi returned from the washroom, folding a handkerchief soaked in water.
これはずいぶんひどい熱や。きっと親族会議のどっけにやられてもうたんやな。今はもう他の親族たちのことは全部忘れるんや。な。
As Hideyoshi spoke to her kindly, he set the soaked handkerchief on Ava's burning forehead. Ava rested her own hand on top of his.
あなたの手、ひんやりして気持ちいい。
わしの手が気持ちいいようじゃ、だいぶ熱が出とるな。安心せい。すぐに薬が効いてくるわ。それにな、わしの手は魔法の手なんや。こうしてエヴァの額に手を当てとるとな、どんな熱も立ちどころに治ってしまうんや。
そうね。あなたの手で私の熱が引かなかったことは一度もないものね。
それこそ、わしの手があれば医者いらずやで。安心して目をつむるんや。すぐにわしの魔法でぐんぐん熱が下がるからな。
うん。知ってる。あなたの魔法を感じるもの。
Hideyoshi was about to call that the placebo effect, but he stopped. If Ava said that she could feel magic from his hand, then that was all right for now.
魔法って本当にあるのかしら？
おお、あるで。信じるものにしかわからへんけどな。そういう魔法は案外世の中にたくさんあるもんや。
魔法が実在するなら、やっぱり魔女も実在するのかしら。
森の魔女ベアトリーチェのことかいな。信じる者にはおるやろな。神様と同じや。信心深い人の前にしか姿は現さんのや。
私もね、昔魔法が使えたの。
ほう、ほんまかいな。じゃあお前も魔女やったんやな。
私がね、絶対に叶えたい夢があって、それを強く願って努力すると、それは必ず叶ったの。私はその魔法でいつも成績は一番だったし、生徒会長にだってなったし、入りたい大学にも実力で入れたし、いつだってどんな願いだって叶えてきたわ。
そうやな。お前の魔法はいつだって大したもんや。 お前は確かに魔女や。そして誰にも負けん努力家や。わしゃよく知っとるで。
私ね、子供の頃からずっとずっと心の中にもう一人の自分がいて、いつも私を励ましてくれたの。そしてその自分は魔女だったわ。森の魔女ベアトリーチェなんて信じなかった。もし六軒島に魔女がいるとしたら、それは私の心の中の魔女のことだってずっと信じてきた。その魔女の自分に私はすごい感謝してる。あなたに出会わせてくれてよかったなっていつも感謝してる。
病気の時のお前はいつも気弱すぎや。今は何も言わんで、熱が下がるまでずっとこうしてるからな。
絶対に手を離さないでね。なんだか私、自分が自分でなくなるような気がして、さっきから怖いの。私の中の魔女がベアトリーチェに触発されてどんどん強くなるような気がして、なんだか私を飲み込んでしまいそうな気がするの。
大丈夫や。わしが一緒にいる限り何も恐れることなんてあらへん。ほら、ちょいとヤバめな国に旅行に行った時、バスごと強盗にやったことあったやろ。
あれ、
わしが撃退したんやで。
You did?
あなた、金時計を渡して拝み倒しただけだったじゃない。かっこ悪いけど、かっこよかったわ。この手、絶対に離さないでね。眠っても絶対に離さないでね。そして何か不気味なものが忍び込んできても、私を守ってね。
おう、任せとかんかい。だから今は安心して眠るんやで。すぐに薬とわしの魔法が効いてくるからな。
Ava finally calmed her heart and closed her eyes. At that time, there was the sound of the door being violently opened from the direction of the lobby. It seemed that Maria was having a tantrum, and screams of ooh could be heard along with Rosa's rebuking yells. That probably hurt Ava's ears. Or maybe she was holding back a headache. Ava moaned as though in pain and buried herself in the covers. It was easy to guess what was happening. Maria had probably had a tantrum for some reason, gone down to the lobby, and started arguing with Rosa as she scolded her daughter. And then, perhaps that was too pitiful to be shown in front of the other relatives, so Rosa had taken Maria out into the corridor. Hideyoshi had no desire to interfere with Rosa and Maria's problem. But just for now, since Ava's condition was so bad, he wanted them to take their ruckus somewhere else.
ちょっと待っとれや。静かにするようお願いしてくるわ。
早く戻ってきて。
Don't worry, I won't be... forgetting what voice I did for him. Hideyoshi removed the chain, opened the door, and stuck his face out into the corridor. He immediately met Rosa's gaze.
大丈夫かいな、ローザさん。
ごめんなさい。うるさくして起こしちゃったかしら。
マリアちゃん、ごめんな。エヴァおばさんな、具合が悪くて寝とるんや。すまんが、ちょいと静かにしてもらえるか。
Maria's tone didn't change after being asked by Hideyoshi. She kept crying and repeating Maria's rose, Maria's rose. Rosa slapped Maria's lifted her up while covering her mouth and dragged her toward the entrance, trying to at least put some distance between her and Hideyoshi's room. She would still probably be lively for a while, but he had warned Rosa for the time being. Relying on Rosa's actions as a mother, Hideyoshi closed the door.
またマリアちゃんが泣いてるの。
そうみたいやな。ローサさんも大変や。それを思えば、うちのジョージはできすぎや。親が感謝したいくらいやで。
そうね。
おお、すまんそう。ほら、魔法の手やで。
He put his hand on Ava's forehead again. Maybe there really was magical power in that hand. A truly peaceful look rose to Ava's face, and bit by bit she began to drift off into the land of sleep. As he had promised, Hideyoshi kept his hand on her forehead. I'll go and take the time to kind of say this. While I do like how Rudolph and Kirie really work off of each other, as much as I don't agree with, well, all I can say is just the connection between Hideyoshi and Ava is just, it's very nice. Hideyoshi, you're a good guy. That, and I respect you greatly. By the entrance, with her hand still against Maria's mouth, Rosa was at a loss for what to do next. She hadn't been able to withstand everyone's gazes in the lobby, and had yelled at the children to go upstairs, dashing out of the lobby. Then she had gone out into the corridor, only to have Hideyoshi say that she was too noisy. Where should I go now? Where should I take this child who's having a tantrum? She felt as though tears of frustration were about to come out. As Maria kept struggling in an attempt to scream, Rosa put her mouth up to Maria's ear. And tried to persuade Maria in a properly calm voice.
Maria wa sonna ni mo bara ga mitai no ne?
Maria nodded her head several times, moaning.
Doushite sonna ni bara ga mitai no? Okaasan ga kiite ageru kara, shizuka ni hanashite. Sakendara naguru wa yo.
Jesus.
Maria no bara, Beatrice ni yomigaerasete moratta no. Mata oreちゃってる kamo. マリアはそれが心配。確かめないと眠れない。
In any event, it seemed that she was still upset about that marked rose from yesterday. Rosa felt her headache throbbing again, but she was at least a little relieved that Maria had now stopped her screaming.
とにかく、今はみんな大変なの。だからママたちに迷惑をかけないで。バラの話は、明日雨が上がったら好きにしていいから。だから今は聞き分けなさい。
やだ、やだ、やだ、やだ、やだ。マリアのベアトリーチェのバラ。
Rosa reflexively covered Maria's mouth. She had spoken a little too harshly and had gotten her agitated again. Rosa realized that it was partly her own fault and clicked her tongue in self-hatred. But Maria thought that was directed at her, and her crying grew even fiercer.
お願いだから静かにして。どうしたらあなたは泣き止むの？どうしたらあなたはママの言うことを聞いてくれるの？
Suddenly, Maria stopped crying so fast that it seemed unnatural. Then she turned around and muttered,
マリアのバラを見たら、ちゃんと明日まで静かにしてるよ。
本当？
うん。バラ庭園に行って、マリアのバラを見たら、もうおとなしくする。本当だよ、ママ。
Something's not right. If it would keep Maria quiet for the time being, Rosa thought that even going out into this wind and rain would be a small price to pay.She thought it might be a bit reckless, but in the end, no murder or anything of the sort had actually occurred. All of that clamor since this morning had been a farce set up by Kinzo. If you carefully thought about that chain of closed rooms, it clearly had to all be an act.
本当にバラを見たらもうおとなしくする?
うん、本当だよ、ママ。
Rosa didn't overlook that creepy laugh and lightly hit Maria with her fist. And she shrugged as though giving up.
わかった。一目見たら納得するのよ。いいわね。
む、ママ。約束する。
I swear, it's that freaking laugh and the freaking smile. Once again, Rosa tested the weight of her gun. It's all right. It's only a farce. There was never a murder on this island in the first place.
Kuso! Mate yo, Rosa-oba-san! Rosa-oba-san to Maria ga... ...daigu no ban no kiseisha nano ka? Kuso, kuso, kuso! Dare ka kizuke yo, yomitame ro! Ima no oyaji tachi ya ore tachi wa nani o shiteru nda?
Rosa 親子の痛々しい関係に気を使って、わざわざ話題を変えておる。そなたらも2階へ上がり、テレビを見ながら話題を変えておる。
くそったれ！誰か気づけよ！一番近くにいるのは誰だよ！秀吉おじさんか！頼むよ！玄関から2人が出ていくのを気づいてくれよ！
届かん、届かん。二人のささやかな時間を邪魔してくれるな。
Hideyoshi kept talking kindly, his hand on Ava's forehead. He didn't notice that Rosa and Maria were going outside through the front door at all. In that case, there was no way that the others in the lobby, which was even further away, would notice. And the cousin's room in the second story was even worse.
そなたは何を慌てておるのか。第一の番人。犯人は事故死したとの大胆な指し手にて、わらわを打ち破ったではないか。ならば、この島に犯人はおらぬことになる。何を心配する必要があるというのか。
うるせえよ、しらしら死んだよ。誰か引き止めろ、二人が殺されるんだ。誰か止めろ。
Oh boy. There was no way that Battler's voiceless scream would reach Rosa and Maria. The two of them could be seen in the rose garden. The rain was still awful, but fortunately the wind had died down a little. No, maybe that wasn't fortunate, because maybe if the wind had been a little fiercer, Rosa might have hesitated to go outside. Maria found her own rose of the gold lace and stared at it lovingly. Rosa had accepted with the promise that Maria would only have one look at it, but she didn't want Maria to complain that it hadn't been enough later on. So she decided to go along with Maria until she was satisfied. She believed that there wasn't a culprit. But on the off chance that she was mistaken, they were now in an extremely dangerous position. Rosa realized that faintly herself. If things got bad, she would throw away her umbrella and ready her gun. After glancing at Maria's innocent happiness, Rosa gazed warily in all directions. Were her eyes just tired? Even though no one should have been there, she thought she saw something glitter in the dark rose garden. Gold-colored... It had to be her imagination. Because, to Rosa, it seemed as though gold butterflies were dancing through the rose bushes.
Are you okay? 無理せんで、やっぱり南條先生を呼んでこんか。
大丈夫だから、この手を離さないで。お願いだから、離さないで。
Ava was breathing wildly. Beads of sweat were appearing on her forehead. It certainly was true that she'd stayed up all night since last night.And that things had been all rough since early this morning. It wasn't odd that her body wasn't keeping up. Even though he understood that, Hideyoshi suspected that the sudden fever was the sign of some serious illness. Several times, Hideyoshi decided to call Dr. Nanjo, but Ava resisted firmly, pleading with him and saying that it was even more important that he didn't take his hand away.
Wakatta. Demo na, ohiru inattara kanarazu Nanjo-sensei ni mite mora. Sore o yakusoku dekiru nara, zutto koko ni ite.お前の手を握ったるからな。こうしてギュッとな。
ありがとう。 丈夫よ。あなたの手の魔法で必ずこんな熱な。
Didn't even realize she was still talking.
下がっちゃうから。
I honestly didn't realize that she was still talking. I thought she actually finished. In which case, sorry. Even as she said that, Ava's harsh breathing didn't improve in the slightest. Ava?
Dare!
She saw an umbrella moving from beyond the rose bush. Rosa threw her umbrella and wildly lifted her gun. When she did, the shadow of a person beyond the bush showed itself.
Oh, Ava Oba-san.
What?
Bikkuri shita wa. Nee-san nano? Nani ka goyo? さっきの話の続きなの。
ええ、そうよ。
お父様の黄金の話よ。
お願いだからマリアの前では遠慮して。ちゃんと約束は守ってるわよ。姉さんの悪だくみの邪魔はしないわ。
悪だくみ？何それ。
姉さんが何を考えていても勝手よ。私は邪魔する気なんてない。だからマリアの前では許して。私は分け前さえもらえれば十分なの。
分け前？
You're different.You're the other Ava. Ava started laughing in a creepy voice. Rosa was startled, but Maria stared blankly. Then Maria said just one thing.
Oh? Opa-san? Sore?
する資格など本当にあると思ってるの？あれは全て私のもの。後ろ宮家当主にして新しき黄金の魔女ベアトリーチェの名を継承した私だけのもの。
ベアトリーチェ、
ベアトリーチェだ。ママ、ベアトリーチェ。
Maria jumped at her mother in ecstasy.Rosa treated Maria cold-heartedly and raised her gun high.
Nee-san, yo ne? Nee-san nano yo ne?
Jigau wa? Watashi wa mohaya anata no ane de atta sonzai dewa nai no.
Ja, anta dare nano yo? ベアトリーチェだとでも言うの？そんなはずはない！あんたは19年前に死んだのよ！ええ、確かに死んでいたわ。だって私、あなたの頭が割れているところをはっきり見たもの。その中身が溢れ出しているのを昨日のことのように思い出せる。
OK, disturbing.
そのあんたがどうして生きてここにいるのよ。
Not like I just had dinner or anything.
黄金の魔女に死の概念などないの。黄金の魔女とベアトリーチェの名は永遠に受け継がれてゆくわ。お前が知っていたベアトリーチェは死を迎えたかもしれないが、今やそれは私の名である。ゆえに無限。ベアトリーチェに死の概念はないの。
あの黄金に気が触れたとしか思えない。哀れね、姉さん。
もはや私はお前の姉ではないというのに。さて、新しきベアトリーチェとして自らの復活の儀式を引き継ぐわ。ロノウェ、私はどうすればいいの？
ご随意のまま。もはやベアトリーチェ様にはどのような思いも実現できる力がおあります。少し扱えばなれるでしょう。
不甲斐なき元妹よ。私が魔女として初めて捧げる最初の生贄に選ばれたことを光栄に思うがいい。
Wait, what?
第2の番に寄り添う二人を私がこの手で引き裂く。
She said first sacrifice. I'm like, wait a minute, is she doing another first twilight? So six more? We're gonna... Okay. 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 She's just picking up where the first Beatrice left off.The first thing the new Beatrice wished, no, the first magic she tried to use was to surpass the limitations given to humans. In particular, gravity. She wanted to become fully aware of her transformation into a witch by being released from those shackles. As the witch and Rosa stayed as they were, the ground retreated all by itself into the distance below them. By now, their feet were no longer attached to the ground. Rosa finally realized that the ground wasn't retreating to the distance below them.But that she and the witch were being sucked up into the rainy sky. Jesus Christ, that face! For a human shackled to the ground by gravity, there was nothing more unnerving than having their feet stop sticking to the ground. However, to Beatrice, who knew the joy of being released from gravity as the new witch, it was enough to cause her whole body to shake with delight.
Hey, Rosa!
Okay, is this gonna be like, anybody who's like a new Beatrice is going to have the most freaky fuck face? You're not gonna drop her, are you?
あなた言ったわ。夢の中で空を飛んだって。そして責めたくなかったとも言ったわ。起こした私を恨んだともね。安心して。今度は覚めないわよ。いや。
Come dance with me in the vast rainy sky.Didn't we both wish we could fly like seagulls in the sky and escape the narrow and boring island of Okajima? Now I'll make that dream a reality for you, because I only wanted to share this joy with you and no one else.
が憧れた大空を自由にする力。 ちは踊るように飛び回ろう。稲光が私たちを照らして祝福してくれるわ。
The witch and Rosa were like leaves floating around in a whirlwind. As the rain pounded upon every part of their bodies, as the lightning occasionally shone upon them, they shook with the joy of being released from the ground. However, it was only that way for the witch. Rosa was holding onto her head, voicelessly screaming over and over. Don't just drop her! A slightly displeased expression rose to the witch's face when she realized that her own joy was not being shared. Then she decided to listen to her former sister's request. The whirlwind that had been making Rosa dance around grew weaker than stopped. In other words, Rosa was once again bound by the restriction of gravity as a human. Following the laws that were originally correct, Rosa began to descend towards the ground upside down. No, she began to fall. The witch hadn't intended to send Rosa plummeting, but she still wasn't used to using magic. Heights is like one of the worst fears I've got. After plummeting about 100 meters into a rose bush, as a very, very natural result, Rosa died instantly. But the witch hadn't intended to kill her, so she wished that Rosa didn't die. When she did, gold butterflies coiled about Rosa's body, reviving that life just as the witch had wished. Rosa's body, which should have been spread out like a carpet of fresh blood, rapidly returned to normal. The broken and crushed bones returned to normal. The torn and smashed flesh returned to normal. How easy it is to break things in this world and how difficult it is to fix them. Anyone can take a life, but no human can revive a lost life. By surpassing the irreversible, one proves that they have surpassed humans. This surely gave her a much, much greater realization that she was a witch than flying through the sky had.
もちろんです。ベアトリーチェ様はすでに無限の命を取らせられます。生きることも死すことも、生かすことも殺すことも、すべてを無限に繰り返される。その輪廻を支配する女王こそが、無限の魔女であるベアトリーチェ様なのです。
鉢を落としたことがあるわ。涼しげな美しい鉢が割れてしまって二度と元に戻らなかった。床に叩きつけられた可愛いデメキは二度と泳ぐ姿を見せてくれなかった。私がいくら泣いても使用人たちは壊れたものと死んだものは蘇らせられない、首を横に振ったっけ。あの時学んだのよ。物は壊しちゃいけない、人は殺しちゃいけないって。だって治せないんだもん。じゃあ治せるなら壊しても怒られないということでしょ。すごい、すごい、すごい、すごい。
For a while, the witch became intoxicated with how terrible and wonderful the power she had succeeded was. Her laugh was pure, innocent, and also cool. Even though Rosa had been revived, she let out a cry of anguish at the pain from her fall. At that point, the witch landed and held out her hand.
そして人間がこんなにもろく死ぬとも知らなかったの。でも生き返らせてあげたからもう平気だから起きて、私ともっと遊びましょう。
Jesus Christ, what the hell is up with your laugh? Oh god, I would take the other Beatrice's laugh over yours, good lord.
What were those dreams you told me about when you were a kid? Go ahead and tell me about all of them without holding back. As I am now, I can make anything come true, no matter how absurd. Even making you fall into a sea of jelly. Even having you get sucked into a mountain of cake. I can even make you spout butterfly wings and let you walk around the garden, okay? I'll do them one after another, so let's start with the ocean of jelly, okay? Rosa was once again thrown high into the rainy sky. However, the sky wasn't filled with raindrops, but with drops of orange juice. When she looked down, Rosa had to doubt her eyes. The rose garden had disappeared, and the ground spread up beneath her was like a pastel-colored jigsaw puzzle. It was from the dream she had talked about when she was young, an ocean of jelly. The black part was coffee jelly. The red was strawberry. The yellow was pineapple. The green was melon. What was the white part? Apple? Did Rosa even have the time to think of something like that? Rosa fell towards that multicolored ocean. And sunk deep into the purple grape-flavored ocean. It really was an ocean of jelly. It had no bottom. As Rosa sank, she was shocked to see a school of transparent fish swimming through the grape jelly ocean. They're probably made of grape skin. Then she sank on and on, deeper and deep as the Mariana's Trench, crushed by the water pressure of the jelly ocean as her ribs... Okay, this episode's just attacking all of my fears. Jesus Christ! Okay. Oh, God. As her spine snapped, in the end, she had become a small, frail meatball. Isn't that a dream? That's a fucking nightmare! The instant I snapped my fingers, the meatball that had been Rosa was launched up into the sky. And after being wrapped up in a golden sparkle, she returned to her original form. It was as simple and easy as returning dried seaweed to its original form, and anyone could do it. If they were a witch. That absent-minded look on Rosa's face has to be because of the joy from having that dream she had given up as a child made into reality. Definitely, probably. Next is the mountain of cake. In an instant, the sky was covered and became black and white in the shape of a chessboard. That almost transparent white part was her favorite rare cheesecake. The elegant black part was a slightly bitter gâteau au chocolat. And that became the ceiling, became a mountain. Several billion cakes were thrown down towards Rosa. If you piled those cakes up, they would surely be taller than Mount Everest. So they probably weighed... I'm not too sure, but it was probably heavier than all the cakes across Japan put together. This is beyond torture. It fell down like a ceiling and swallowed Rosa up. So as a very, very natural result, Rosa was crushed to death. In less than a second, her bones broke throughout her body and her insides were all smashed and forced out. Squish. And even so, an even greater number of cakes piled on top, and Rosa ended up as a layer of jam wedged between the cakes. She became as thick as a single hair and was probably smashed out into the area of a tennis court. That world swallowed up by cake was once again absorbed by a gold flash. Then, as though it had all been a dream, Rosa was revived once again. Of course, it definitely wasn't a dream. She'd been revived after dying. By that point, death, which almost humans only have to experience once after they are born, had already been experienced repeatedly by Rosa. In other words, she had gone through that which humans cannot, the precious experience of dying more than once. Beato, I already miss your laugh. Good lord, Beato's laugh was like listening to a beautiful harp compared to this. Laughing innocently, she pointed her gold staff at Rosa as she begged for mercy. When she did, Rosa glittered gold and rapidly began to shrink. She shrank down to the size of a real butterfly. Then gold wings sprouted from her back and she joined her fellow gold butterflies. However, while a human body could withstand that wind, it was a different matter for a butterfly's body. The gold butterfly Rosa was invited to a dance by each gale of wind, and she spun in circles around the girl's garden. As her dance wore her out, she was caught by a gentle bed. It was the soft, knit hammock in the shadows beneath the roof of the arbor. The owner of that hammock lumbered into view, welcoming its rare guest who had wandered in on the night of the storm. That owner, which should have been small enough to crush in the palm of your hand, now looked as big as the top of the canopy bed to Rosa. Oh God! Jesus! Good Lord! You granted my wish. At least I got to hear your beautiful voice again. I feel like vomiting.
あんなに楽しそうじゃないかよ。無理もない。魔法は楽しいもんな。思い出すよ。わらわも魔法が使えるようになった時はすっごくはしゃいだもんさ。わかるぜ。あのはしゃぎっぷりが心の底からわかるさ。この喜びや感動。 バトラには共感できないんだろうな。ああ、残念残念。バトラだってわらわを認めればいつだって魔法を教えてやるぞ。人間の束縛を逃れた瞬間の喜びは筆舌に尽くしがたい。そなたに教えてやりたいよ。あの喜び、あの感動。 あなたの生み出す魔法の世界もぜひ一度見てみたいものだ。楽しくなってきただろう。魔法が使いたくなってきただろう。魔女もなかなかに楽しいものであるぞ。特別に教えてやる。一緒に空を飛ぶ喜びと 一緒に海を潜る喜びとか、人間の制約を超えた瞬間に知る世界がどれほどに広かったのかという感動をそなたにも教えてやる。
There was no malice in Beato's expression. It was hard to believe, but she was genuinely enjoying this cool show, and she wanted to share that appreciation with Battler. Battler was shocked by that hopelessly different measure of value.
Valkyria, この愚かな茶番を止めさせるんだ。どうすりゃいいんだ。
私たちは万能の存在です。盤上には触れられません。
Virgilia shook her head apologetically. Her body had already been killed. Did that mean she couldn't interfere in any way? As Beatrice continued to look interested in an insane sort of way, Battler lifted her up by the collar and yelled at her.
Yamero, yamero, yamero! Iikagen ni shiro, majome! Are ga Eva Oba-san datte no ka? Arienai! Ore no shitte Eva Oba-san wa tashika ni ijiwaru na toko mo sukoshi wa atta kedo.こんな残酷なことをする人じゃ断じてありえない。全てお前のまやかしだ。ローザおばさんをもてあそぶな。エヴァおばさんをもてあそぶな。今すぐこの茶番を止めさせろ。
だからローザと遊んでいるのはもうわらわではないというに、新しきベアトリーチェだというに、何ギャーギャーわめくほどに残酷か。そなたもこういうの実は結構好きだろうが、実はちょっぴり魔法に興味を持ってきて。な、何をする。
For the first time, Battler slapped Beato's cheek. Beatrice didn't know why he had done something like that to her, and a surprised expression rose to her face.Battler especially couldn't forgive that expression, and he roared.
これが面白いだ。お前の頭はどうなってんだ。死ね。頭を輪切りにして、てめえで覗いてみろ。設定に中身がごっそり抜けてるぜ。
Battler?
今すぐやめさせろ。この悪趣味な茶番をやめさせるんだ。俺はお前を許さない。僕もこんな残酷なことを、お前のことを少しでも笑えるやつだと思ったこともあったが、俺はもう、お前はただ残酷なだけの怪物だ。俺の前に現れるな。二度とだ。お前を認めない、お前と話さない、お前の顔など見たくもない。聞こえたか。俺の前に現れるな。お前なんか消えてしまえ。
What the hell? What the hell just... The instant Battler screamed, the power that resisted the witch became a red wall and knocked Beato back onto her butt.
だというのだ。面白い見物ではないかよ。
She spoke as though making an excuse, but the person those words were directed at, Battler, was no longer there. His figure had suddenly disappeared into the darkness.But Beatrice looked displeased and continued trying to explain herself. Do you not get it?
ここまでへそを曲げられるものでもあるまいに。
She was hoping for approval, but Virgilia simply faced her with an indifferent expression. To Beato, at that moment, even a surprised face would probably have seemed better.
私から特に言うことはありません。あなたが楽しいと思うなら、いつまでも見続けていると良いでしょう。終わったら呼びなさい。それまで私の姿を消します。
Following Battler's lead, Virgilia hid herself in the darkness. Beato, who was now completely isolated, didn't have a clue what was going on. feeling that they were making her out to be the bad guy. No!
なあ、ロノウェ、そこまで怒るほどじゃないよな。
お嬢様が面白いが、マトラ様にも面白いとは限りません。
わらわ。
えっと。
それは確かに対戦相手だから敵同士ではあるの。妥協笑い合いのこと。わらわたちは不仲だというのか。
It's not entertainment!
バトラと一緒に拍手できたように一緒にゲラゲラ笑い合えると思ったのに、その程度のことでわらわは拒絶されるというのか。
Why do you act like you actually want to be friends with Balor?
魔女だと認めぬのは無理さ。それを競い合うゲームなんだ。
Are you actually crying?
これ
までお嬢様は十分に嫌われるだけの差し手をいたしました。悪魔の私ですね。マトラさんの気持ちが少しはわかるという。それが理解できないのは、お嬢様が特に鈍感が過ぎるのではないかと。
うるさい、うるさい、うるさい、うるさい！お前も消えてしまえ！
はい、かしこまりました。それでは、失礼いたします。
Even Ronove hid himself in the darkness and Beatrice was left alone.The only one in the Rainy Rose Garden. A lonely witch who no one would play with. Because no one would play with her, she was a lonely witch. Behind the witch that was continuing her mad banquet, Beato showed herself. That expression was very rare for her. It was kind of restrained, unreliable, miserable.
これは先代ベアトリーチ様。ご覧くださりましたか？魔法の力は本当に素晴らしい。魔女に生まれ変わることができたことを今ほど楽しいと思ったことはありません。まるでいつまでも終わらぬお遊戯の時間のよう。そう。仙台様もご一緒に遊びましょう。その前にちょっとお待ちになってくださいね。二人はオーブンの中で焼け焦げて死んでしまったから、また蘇らさないと。まるでイーストで膨れるパンみたいに、オーブンの中で膨れるクッキーみたいに。
話を聞けというのに。第二の番の生贄にはもう十分であろう。
Wait, what?
確かに殺し方については指定がないが、それ以上もてあそぶことはあるまいね。
何をおっしゃいます仙台様。さっきロノウェイから聞きましたよ。仙台様の魔法はもっともっと素敵で残酷でやりたい放題だったって。
6人のお腹からお菓子があふれ出すハロウィンパーティーなんて本当に素敵。
ならば私はアリスのお茶会を演出しようかしら。
何でもない日を祝うお茶会にみんなを招待して、私が魔法で次々おもてなしするの。先導様みたいに素敵にできるかしら。個性的に残酷にポップにキュートにできるかしら。
Why? What is with witches and weird faces?
今思うと、
Oh god, that's worse.
とかってどれも残酷でしたよね。
Well, I mean, you're not wrong.
そのおとぎ話の魔女に自らがなってみて、ようやく理解しました。
Beato, I don't know what you're doing, but could you please just do it?
Warawa もその以前までも少しやりすぎたかなって少しは思っておった。まあ黄金の魔女たるもの、少しは気品があっても良いかと思う。
ん？先代様が何をおっしゃってるのか分かりません。でも一つだけ分かります。今の私がどれほど尽くしても先代様の残酷さには到底及びません。もっともっと頑張らなくちゃ。
What?
もっと残酷になって立派な黄金の魔女にならなくちゃ。
だからそれはもう十分だというに。とにかくわらわの先代としての命令だ。第二の番はもう十分だ。わらわが少し手本を見せる。下がって見ておく。
はい、先代様。
どんな無残で残酷でおぞましい殺し方を見せてくれるのか楽しみです。
The new witch grasped the sides of her skirt and gave a graceful bow, stepping back as an expectant gaze rose to her face.She was expecting an even more cruel magic that surpassed even herself.
そういう殺し方しかできないうちは半人前なのだ。わらわが上品な黄金の魔女らしい殺し方を見せよう。
When Beato waved her pipe, seven colors of smoke poured out, reviving Rosa and Maria.Compared to how the new Beatrice had done it a short while ago, it was slightly gentler. It was probably gentler than how Beato had done it herself up until now. Rosa's consciousness had already grown dim from the pains of so many repeated deaths, but even so, she pleaded that her daughter be spared.
Oh, forgive me. せめて、マリアだけでも、許して。
我が弟子がそれ少し羽目を外しすぎたのだ。
You're actually a pull. What the hell? What? When Maria realized it was the real Beatrice, she jumped onto her. And witches are supposed to keep their promises, right?
truly is quiet, and I'll give you a sleep that will never be troubled again. Maria was embraced by the loving expression on Vieto's face. Then, softly, a red bruise appeared on Maria's neck. It was a very gentle bruise. Its redness grew bit by bit, and when it distantly formed itself into the shape of a hand, Maria's neck tilted suddenly, peacefully as though she had fallen asleep.
Mario!
Vieto softly, gently lifted her finger, as though touching the empty air in front of her nose. When she did, a light breeze lifted up, making Rosa's body dance lightly like a feather. Then, Rosa's body floated lightly, and there was the garden fence with its spear-shaped prongs. The spear of the fence pierced Rosa's medulla oblongata, benevolently, without toying with her in a single blow. Rosa's life was snapped out. Compared to the earlier innocent yet cruel events, it seemed to be over much too fast in the end. It looked just like a doll shaped like Rosa was leaning against the fence. But she had passed away. Vieto. Vieto acted proud, but the new witch wore a blank expression almost as though this was an anti-climax. Then she said it out loud.
せっかく素敵なことが無限にできる魔法なのに、つまらない。これ愚痴るでない。黄金の魔女の道は一日にしてならずだ。そなたとて第十の番を終えるまでは半人前よ。今は黙ってわらわの指導に従うのだ。よいな。返事はどうした。返事は。 それでよい、それで。まあ、まだ復活の儀式の先は長いぞ。あと5人も殺さねばならないからな。あまりもてあそばずに、きれいに、上品に。少しあっさりめでいいからな。炉の上のそなたに教えたわらわのやり方は、その、模範にしてはならぬ。 よく心に刻んでおけ。はい、仙台様。良い返事だ。炉の上、煉獄の七姉妹よ。いでよ。はい、お嬢様。炉の上、ここに。傲慢のルシファー、ここに。これまではだな。
As Ronove laughed at Beato's uncharacteristically flustered speech, he summed it up for her.
かしこまりました. Igo wa ōgon no majo no na ni fusawashii kihin ni kii o tsukeru you ni itashimasu. Rengoku no nana shimai mo koremade no you na warufuzake wa aratame. 以後は最短の手順で任務を遂行するように。 ということでよろしいですか、お嬢様。
うん、つまりはそういうことだ。みんな肝に銘じよ。いよいな。
はい、かしこまりました。
わらわが言いたいのは以上だ。もう引き上げてよいぞ。
かしこまりました。それでは失礼いたします。
失礼いたします。
ま、わらわが言いたいのはそれだけだ。それでは引き続きしっかりな。黄金の魔女らしく貫禄を持って、その頑張るがよいぞ。そなたを見守っておる。
Acting unsure until the very end, Beato communicated only that. Became a group of gold butterflies and hid her form in the empty air. She didn't have any business there, so it might be fitting to say that she disappeared in a hurry. After that, all that remained was Maria's corpse, lying down and pounded by the rain. Rosa's corpse, propped up by the fence and staring up at the sky.And the figure of the witch. Her expression looked just a little bored. There was a popping sound. That was probably her clicking her tongue.
つまんないやつ。
Leaving that last sentence behind, she once again hid her form in the empty air.What the fuck? Beatrice? I'm going to save now. Just hold on.As expected. Solved the riddle of the witch's epitaph and was welcomed as the new Endless Witch. She has a natural ability in magic and is expected to grow into an extraordinary great witch. This genius witch often indulged in her own power during her younger days. This is a test permitted only to geniuses, and if she succeeds, her name will probably be listed in the history of Endless Witches.Will she be able to overcome the test which defeated her predecessors? Beatrice? What the hell? I am very much speechless at the moment. I'm sick to my stomach and extremely confused in the head right now.But I certainly know one thing. Eva Beatrice is extremely dangerous. And something is going on with current Beatrice right now. Something Battler did. Just the way he snapped at her. And I...Something in Beatrice's personality changed there, granting a merciful death to Maria and Rosa. I'm going to save, and I'm going to leave this here. Thank you, sir, for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next video.